Hello, this is Christina. Welcome back to my channel. Look at how cute all of these are. I thought we'd do a quick little craft with me tutorial today on making these cute little button pinwheels. So let's get started. These are going to be so cute on the covers, on you know, tags, anything, your journaling pages, clusters. So I thought I would try out this page today. I think this will look really good on the pinwheels. And then I haven't done just a plain paper, so I thought I'd try this one out too. So I'm using a 1-inch punch for this. And that's because that's all I have that isn't packed. I'd like to try a 3/4 inch punch. So if you have a 3/4, try that. And of course, the larger your punch is, the larger your flowers are going to be. And yeah, I'd really like to make some smaller ones. And I think you need about 8 to 10 somewhere around that number. So we're just gonna punch out a few so we have them, and I think I probably have enough now. All right, let's see what we have. So what you do is you take one and you leave that alone. You take the others and you just fold them in half. So get a good fold. You want to get a good fold. So you might want to get your bone folder out or use your nail. And get those sharp. So who's watching Rach and Bella's new collab? I think it is so fun, these collaborations that Rachel has been putting on. I just love watching what each person does each day. And she has some great artists in that collaboration as well. Yeah, I love watching collabs. Okay. Yeah, our weather is still chilly today. I'm wearing sweatpants in here. I thought we had seen the last of it here in Florida. But they say this will be the last cold front. So, I hope so. Not that I'm looking forward to 90 degree weather, but I'm over the cold. I like it at a good 70. That would be ideal. All right. So, I just like to give them some definition. Do both sides and the end piece, the flat piece, flat side, I should say. And you get lots of ink on your fingers with these. I won't do all of these. I'll do what I think I need. And yeah, you can put anything in the center. It doesn't have to be buttons. A nice size crystal. All right, let's see how that works. And all you do is get your wet glue, and I'm using art glitter glue. And if you can see, you're just putting glue just on the tip of that. And then you're gluing it there. Now, you want to make sure that your next one, it's going in the same direction. So you, it's almost a mindless activity, but not quite. Yeah, the mindless activities are the best, aren't they? When you really want to craft, but you're too tired to come up with an idea or to do a full-fledged project, that's when you can break out the mindless activity. You kind of want to space them the same. I saw this and I cannot remember. I'll have to look it up for you. The name, her name is on the tip of my tongue too. But I saw her doing this. So I want to give credit to her. So there's one. Now where'd my buttons go? There's some buttons. I don't have many. Everything's packed. This last one you'll close up. And I think that will be a good one there. And it doesn't matter if you messed up a little bit on the spacing, whatever you put in the center kind of, you know, takes away from that. And nothing in junk journals is perfect. Now I'm using Fabri-Tac 3-in-1 for this. It will hold the button better, I feel. You use whatever glue you have, what works for you. So that is pretty. I'm very happy with using the script. That I think that looks excellent. Let's try some plain paper. I have not done plain paper. And I think I'm going to have plenty of these to use in my projects. I think these will look cute too. And if I had some pink paper, let me see if that's enough. We will try it. I'm getting ready to work on a journal. And it has a lot of pink in it. So I might use this one in that journal. And then the ones where I have the bow, I just strung the twine. And again, you can use any type of string, but I just strung it through the button before I glued the button down. And then once the glue took hold of it and dried is when I tied the bow. It was easier, unless you have a second set of hands that can help you. It was easier. So I'm gonna ink these up, add some color and dimension. And yeah, they're so small that it's getting all over my fingers. And I am getting both sides. And I'm thinking I'll either use that clear button or that purple button on this one. The clear one would make it to where I can use this in any journal. And I'm partial to vintage. That's why I pulled a brown cardstock. And this is, these papers you want lightweight cardstock. It would be easier than using a really thick paper. And that's what I've used. I will show you the script paper we used came from a paper pack from Park Lane that I got at Joann's. And it is an awesome 8x8 paper pad. Let me show that to you. So it's maps, texts, and ledgers. And 180 sheets. And it is absolutely beautiful paper. Lots of different ledger papers. Lots of different everything. I'm about to drop it. So yeah, if you can, go get one. I think I dropped one. Go get one of those. All right, so this one, I turned the other way. No reason for it. That's just how I picked it up. This is more of a lefty doing it this way. It's harder. So weird. So yeah, I'm liking this brown. What do you think of it? Doesn't have to be a pattern paper. Add a little more glue to that. I think I'm gonna add one more. What do you think?